Narrated by Aisha. We set out with Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him, shortly before the appearance of the new moon of Dhu al-Hijjah, and he said, whoever wants to assume Ihram for Umrah may do so, and whoever wants to assume Ihram for Hajj may do so. Had not I brought the Hadi with me, I would have assumed Ihram for Umrah. Some of the people assumed Ihram for Umrah while others for Hajj. I was amongst those who had assumed Ihram for Umrah. I got my menses before entering Mecca, and was menstruating till the day of Arafat. I complained to Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him, about it. He said, abandon your Umrah, undo and comb your hair, and assume Ihram for Hajj. So I did that accordingly. When it was the night of Hasba, day of departure from Mina, the Prophet peace be upon him sent Abdurrahman with me to At-Tanim. The sub-narrator adds, he, Abdurrahman, let her ride behind him. And she assumed Ihram for Umrah in lieu of the abandoned one. Aisha completed her Hajj and Umrah, and no Hadi, Sadaqah, charity, or fasting was obligatory for her. Narrated by Al-Aswad. That Aisha said, O Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him. The people are returning after performing the two nishuks, Hajj and Umrah, but I am returning with one only. He said, wait till you become clean from your menses and then go to At-Tanim, assume Ihram, and after performing Umrah, join us at such and such a place. But it, the reward if Umrah, is according to your expenses or the hardship, which you will undergo while performing it. Narrated by Aisha. We set out assuming the Ihram for Hajj in the months of Hajj towards the sacred precincts of Hajj. We dismounted at Saraf and the Prophet peace be upon him said to his companions, whoever has not got the Hadi with him and likes to make it as Umrah, he should do it, but he who has got the Hadi with him should not do it. The Prophet peace be upon him and some of his wealthy companions had the Hadi with them, so they did not finish Ihram after performing the Umrah. The Prophet peace be upon him came to me while I was weeping. He asked me the reason for it. I replied, I have heard of what you have said to your companions and I cannot do the Umrah. He asked me, what is the matter with you? I replied, I am not praying. He said, there is no harm in it as you are one of the daughters of Adam and the same is written for you as for others. So you should perform Hajj and I hope that Allah will enable you to perform the Umrah as well. So I carried on till we departed from Mina and halted at Al-Mahasab. The Prophet peace be upon him called Abdurrahman and said, go out of the sanctuary with your sister and let her assume Ihram for Umrah, and after both of you have finished the Tawaf I will be waiting for you at this place. We came back at midnight and the Prophet peace be upon him asked us, have you finished? I replied in the affirmative. He announced the departure and the people set out for the journey and some of them had performed the Tawaf of the Kaaba before the morning prayer, and after that the Prophet peace be upon him set out for Medina. Narrated by Safwan bin Yala bin Umayyah from his father who said, a man came to the Prophet peace be upon him while he was at Girina. The man was wearing a cloak which had traces of kaluk or safra, a kind of perfume. The man asked the Prophet peace be upon him, what do you order me to perform in my Umrah? So Allah inspired the Prophet peace be upon him divinely and he was screened by a place of cloth. I wished to see the Prophet peace be upon him being divinely inspired. Umar said to me, come. Will you be pleased to look at the Prophet peace be upon him while Allah is inspiring him? I replied in the affirmative. Umar lifted one corner of the cloth and I looked at the Prophet peace be upon him who was snoring. The sub-narrator thought that he said, the snoring was like that of a camel. When that state was over, the Prophet peace be upon him asked, where is the questioner who asked about Umrah? Put off your cloak and wash away the traces of kaluk from your body and clean the safra, yellow color, and perform in your Umrah what you perform in your Hajj, the Tawaf round the Kaaba and the Sa'i between Safa and Marwa. Narrated by Hisham ibn Urway from his father, who said, "While I was a youngster, I asked Aisha, the wife of the Prophet, 'What about the meaning of the statement of Allah, verily, the mountains, as Safa and Al-Marwa, are among the symbols of Allah? So it is not harmful if those who perform Hajj or Umrah of the house, Kaaba at Mecca, to perform the going, Tawaf, between them.'" Surah 2 verse 158. I understand from that there is no harm if somebody does not perform the Tawaf between them. Aisha replied, "No, for if it were as you are saying, then the recitation would have been like this: it is not harmful not to perform Tawaf between them." This verse was revealed in connection with the Ansar who used to assume the Ihram for the idol Manat, which was put beside a place called Qudayd, and those people thought it not right to perform the Tawaf of As-Safa and Al-Marwa. When Islam came, they asked Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him, about that, and Allah revealed, "Verily, the mountains, as Safa and Al-Marwa, are among the symbols of Allah. So it is not harmful of those who perform Hajj or Umrah of the house, Kaaba at Mecca, to perform the going, Tawaf, between them." Surah 2 verse 158. Sufyan and Abu Muawiyah added from Hisham, from Aisha, the Hajj or Umrah of the person who does not perform the going, Tawaf, between As-Safa and Al-Marwa is incomplete in Allah's sight.